What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the BTR Garage. My name is Justin. In today's video, we're going to be reviewing the Blackstone oil analysis from my 2022 GR86. This was after we pulled the RTV out of the oil pickup. We did an oil sample when we drained that oil. So we're going to see how much silicone is in that oil sample. So the first thing we're gonna start with is actually a quick recap of my 2017 Subaru BRZ with the FA 2.0 or the FA 20 2-liter engine and what that looked like when I did the oil analysis on that. Now, obviously it's a different engine. The mileage was different when I did it on the BRZ, but it gives a little bit of background context of what these analyses contain and the types of things that are in the analysis. I'm gonna read the comments section on the 2017 BRZ real quick. It says the initial sample from your BRZ has some extra metals and silicone in it. These aren't surprising finds considering this appears to be just the second oil change. Metals show wear in at new parts. Silicone is harmless, used from the factory, etc., etc. That stuff should wash out over the next few oil changes. And looking at their report, you can see we had several of the metals and other things over the universal average at the time. So again, this was a early oil change on the car. I think the car had, 10,000 miles on it, had about 5,000 miles on the oil. So I had a couple more oil changes than my GR86, but there were higher levels of iron and copper, higher levels of silicone, etc., over the universal averages. And according to the Blackstone oil analysis, nothing to be worried about. Now, moving on to the GR86 report. So this information is current as of just a few weeks back. So when I did the oil change, I had just about 4,000 miles on the car, not quite there, and almost 3,000 miles on the oil change. So keep in mind, when I did this analysis, I already had a few autocross days on the car, about 40 autocross runs, lots of banging off the rev limiter and driving the car like crazy in autocross, and then a full track day out at Utah Motorsports Campus, which is a 3+ mile track, very high average speed, high speed, long sweepers, and that type of stuff. So that stuff was all before I had cleaned my oil pickup, before I had done the oil analysis. So we'll start off with the comments from Blackstone. I had made a note in my request that there had been an engine failure or two due to oiling or lack of oiling in the bearings. They were not familiar with any of that, so that's what that note is about. They did indicate there were no signs of poor bearing wear in the report. So the aluminum and the tin, the bearings metals, they were okay, so no issues there. Copper from brass and bronze parts was elevated, but this can be due to lingering wear in of brass and bronze parts. High silicone is common in young engines. It's from sealer and lube. We know there's a lot in these particular engines. And the comments continue to say, we'll look for copper and silicone to wash down with each oil change. The FA24D should eventually start to resemble universal averages, which are based on roughly 3,400 miles. So that's good news, hearing from Blackstone on what their analysis was for the levels of aluminum and tin, the bearing metals, and then the amount of silicone. So looking at the actual numbers themselves, you guys can see the aluminum, the tin, those are all right around the universal averages, as they mentioned in the comments. There is a good bit more silicone in my GR86 oil analysis compared to my 2017 BRZ, which can be expected just based on the mileage difference in the amount of oil changes. So 129 parts per million of silicone in my GR86 after roughly 4,000 miles of driving, whereas my Subaru BRZ, my 2017, had 81 parts per million, and that was, you know, over 10,000 miles of driving. So a lot more driving, a lot more time for that stuff to flush out of the system. It makes sense. But we'll continue to look at these numbers. The rest of the numbers are pretty close to their universal averages, a little bit higher in some cases. But as mentioned by Blackstone, that's pretty normal. That stuff will wash out and be a little more closer to the universal averages as you get more oil changes, more wear in on the engine. If you guys have any thoughts or comments, please leave them down below. And definitely, if you've done your own Blackstone oil analysis on a 2022 GR86 or BRZ, do include that information down below in the comments. I'd like to see if, you know, others have similar contents of metals and silicone and things in their own tests. So thanks again, everybody, for watching. I really appreciate it. Stick around. We got more good stuff coming up very soon. Stay safe out there. I am checking out. We'll talk to you all next time.